Okay, you guys, as you can see, this wig is super old. I bought it last year for my birthday. I was turning 24 and I needed something quick and pretty. So I went to the hair store and bought this wig that was called buttalace. It's real popular right now because the wig is HD and also come pre-plucked. And plus, it was real pretty and wavy. But as you can see, I threw it in my damn hair bag and I just didn't take care of it. Now it's really nappy and matted. And I wanted to fix it. So right now I'm just brushing it through, getting all those knots and all those tangled hair that's all together, just brushing it out. Okay, so after you get done brushing it out, you're gonna boil some very hot water. Yes, I know that my pot is raggedy. I only use it for when I boil water for my hair and when I wanna pour the hair. So as you can see, the water is extremely hot, so please be careful. What I did was sit a bucket underneath the hair so it can catch the water, and I'm just pouring it all over. And as you can see, as soon as that hot water touches that hair, it straightens it out. It also makes it soft once it dries, but I will show y'all that later on in the video. But right now, as you can see, I am just pouring this hot boiling water everywhere on the wig, the ends, the sides, the back. So yeah. Okay, so after you get done boiling your first batch of water and pouring it on top of your wig, what you're gonna do is take the brush that you use to untangle your wig with and brush it out. Just brush it out and just get it straight. So when you take another pot of boiling water, it's gonna make it even straighter, especially since you done brushed it out. Okay, so we're on our second batch of boiling water. I'm gonna pour water on the other side, and of course, to make that side straight as well, just pour the water everywhere as much as you can, just to get all of the strings at least straight enough to the point when it's time to flat iron, it won't be hard to flat iron basically. So just keep pouring that boiling water on the sides. Once again, please be careful. As you can see, I got mittens on because that pot was extremely hot to hold. And also make sure that water is catching at the bottom where the bucket is so it don't get on your floor, on your feet, because that can leave a bad burn. Also, as you can see here, I'm combing it through again, just getting it as straight as possible. Sorry, you guys, I wasn't recording this part, but you do pour hot boiling water on top of the hair 2 to 3 times again, and you wait for it to air dry 2 to 3 hours. Okay, it's time to flat iron. Do you see how pretty the hair is already looking? And we haven't even started the flat iron process yet. But of course, the ends are still a little tangled, so I just decided to cut the ends just to save time and all that crazy mess. I just decided to go ahead and just clip the ends so it could make it an easier process. Okay, so on this process, I'm not gonna talk as much because all you're doing now is just taking piece by piece of the hair, flat iron it real good till it's bone straight, and also to clip your ends so it won't be tangled. And we're also trying to make this process as easy as we can and quick. But yes, just take your flat iron and go over the hair piece by piece and make it really as straight as possible as you want it. Okay, so on this part, I'm not gonna lie, I got lazy. So I just flattened all the hair barely and was just like, look, I'm just gonna cut the ends and we're gonna just take it piece by piece and make sure everything is just bone straight at this point. Because I was working on this hair all morning by boiling it and stuff. So I just got lazy. Now I'm just cutting the tangled ends off, just trying to hurry up this process.
Thank you.
Okay, boom. We're about done flat ironing. Look how pretty that wig looks. It's a totally different wig already. So now it's time to bend the ends. And what I mean by bending the ends, I don't want my synthetic hair looking too straight and you can tell that it's synthetic. So what we're going to do is take my curling comb. You can get it from Dollar Tree, Dollar General, Walmart, whatever you would like to go. And take the blow dryer, and while you're combing and curling at the same time, you're going to take the blow dryer and have it right in front of it so that heat can make it bend. Okay, so after you get done curling with your curling comb and also with the blow dryer, I just go back through it again with the flat iron. And when I reach the end of my hair, I curl it going the same way I did with my blow dryer so it can give it that extra bump. Now I'm just admiring this wig. Oh my goodness, I can't believe how different it looks. I'm sorry, you guys, I did not capture me installing the wig, but this is me with the wig on. This is how it came out. And I know we was ready to go out to eat that night, so I was trying to hurry up. But thank you for watching. Tune in and subscribe, please. Thank you.